With shovels in hand and smiles for the cameras, Governor Rick Scott joined GE Energy Management CEO Mark Begor, Clearwater Mayor George Cretekos, Pinellas County Commissioner Norm Roche, and State Representative Ed Hooper in breaking ground on GE's new Manufacturing Center of Excellence. The new 190,000 square foot facility will encompass the existing manufacturing facility and add 250 more jobs to the state and Pinellas County economy.
A $50 million investment, 250 plus jobs. And generally, my experience with this is, even just in the last 3.5 years, as you create more jobs, when you have success, more jobs get created. So I want to thank everybody at GE for their focus on it, spending this $50 million in Florida, in the great state of Florida, and the 250 more jobs here. So thank you very much, everybody at GE.
Multiple partnering agencies, including Enterprise Florida, the City of Clearwater, Pinellas County, Duke Energy, Pinellas County Economic Development, and the Department of Economic Opportunity made the project possible. The new Center of Excellence facility represents a reinvestment in Clearwater, where GE currently employs 430 workers and has had a presence in the city for almost 40 years.
We know, whether you're in Clearwater or in Tallahassee or at the county, we realize that we can't do this by ourselves, that we need partners, and the federal government and Congressman Jolly's office has been there for us, just like Congressman Young's office was there previously. So thank to all of you for the investment that you're making in our home, in our home community of Clearwater.
We always think about bringing new jobs in, but in new businesses, but retention and expansion is very important.
It is equally important. You're right, Libby. It's very much important because you have a lot of folks out there, and this is a struggling and fragile economy, so we're in competition, and they're coming after businesses like our hometown, our GE Club, and want to get them over into their area. So although they're here and it's their home, we're still in a competitive nature, so we have to make it our best efforts to keep them here and expanding here. And the QTI program, the one that's coming up also on the ballot in the primary, another good program. We need tools in our economic development toolbox, and tools like these that actually give us a return on that investment before we invest. You can't beat that. It's a great day. It really is.
Anytime there's a change in the way a company is doing their job, they're looking at every existing facility and every new opportunity, and we came out ahead of this. The business climate, the labor force that's available here, the track record at the current plant, all of that came into play in trying to recruit this company down here. And it could have gone either way, and it could have gone anywhere in the country. That's the problem. Every GE facility is looked at on a regular basis, and they compete internally on contracts. This plant has to prove it's better than a plant, you know, in Michigan or Texas, you know, so it's exciting when we win.
The facility currently manufactures instrument transformers, while the new facility will add the production of capacitors for customers worldwide.
We have 450 employees today, and we'll take that to 750 over the next 12 months. And we want to thank Governor Scott and the rest of his team for their great support to our project here, and we're excited to move forward. Thank you very much.
And it's companies like GE and the state of Florida that benefit from Florida's long view of workforce development to retain and attract high-wage jobs.
One thing is $30 million more in workforce training for STEM-oriented occupations. We need to make sure, I have grandchildren, we need to make sure they're trained and they're ready for the workforce of the future, whether it's historic funding in K-12, state colleges, universities, performance funding for any universities, but it's a big focus on science, technology, engineering, and math.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Clearwater and Pinellas County had a great day with more jobs and a boosted economy. For Good Business Pinellas, I'm Libby Bowling.